moment I need to record this, I'm gonna have to click the button record so that we can post this again via the internet. Oh, it's recording right now. Without any further ado or gilding the lily, because he's well known worldwide already. So let's just simply welcome right here inside the booth. Congratulations, of course, 89.5 for having, di ba? Ang ating gabutihing congressman, JV Ejercito. Konti palakpak naman po, everyone. Magandang hapon po, sir.
Magandang hapon din. Good afternoon to all the listeners of 89.5 here in Subic Bay. And us, of course, to all our kababayans around the world, magandang hapon sa inyo lahat at mabuhay kayo.
Okay, that's right. We are a worldwide FM radio station. Most of our viewers, other countries, of course, are Filipinos who used to live here or working now somewhere. But most of our local listeners as well via radio sets. Now, before po tayo magpunta sa one of the reasons why you're here, just want to find out more about Congressman JB Ejercito. How do you find Subic Bay Freeport, po, sir?
Well, of course, ever since the U.S. bases closed down, no, and I think that this is one of the potential growth areas that the country has developed since in the 90s, no. Kasi noong mga panahon, sabi nila, pag nawala ang U.S. bases, baka mamatay ang Olongga po. But I think we have proven that through the years that Subic Bay has given jobs and opportunities to a lot of our kababayans here, and I always admire, no, the of course the people of Olongapo, Zambales, for the resiliency, and at least we are here, we are alive, and at least we have more opportunities to look forward to in the coming years.
Well, thank you so very much, sir. Medyo dagdagan ko lang ng konting question ko noon. Medyo curious lang din kasi. Nanggaling na po yung po ba kayo before nyo nandito pa ang US Naval Base, no? Napasok yun na siya?
I think once lang, no? But of course, I've been here after na. When we opened, when Subic Bay opened, I see quite a number of time. And of course, every time I need to relax and to relieve my stress, I come here to Subic, and it's not only the place, of course the people are friendly, so it's a good time, it's a good place, no, to be able to unwind and to relax, no? There's a lot of things to do here.
Sir, every now and there po pala, sir, pag medyo naghahanap kayo ng konting relaxation, you know, R&R, tumatakbo kayo rito sa Subic Bay.
Yes, of course. And sometimes in conventions and other functions, no, that are being held here, once in a while I get invited as guest speaker, mm-hmm, or as guest. And sometimes it's our own organization, the JCI or the JCs. We have held a lot of activities here in the past, no? So, and I'm glad that Subic is still very much vibrant, very much alive, and a lot of activities are happening, especially this summertime.
That's right. Okay, napag-usapan nga po natin conventions, so forth and so on, mga nagiging guest speakers kayo. And right now, at this very moment, kanina po ba natapos na? Hindi pa, or mag-ano pa lang
diba,
po kayo?
Itong 5:30 to 6 p.m. Okay. I'll be one of the guest speakers also in the SK Region 3 SK Summit here in held here in Subic.
Subic. Sa may harapan lang naman po ng station yan, which is the Travelers Inn Hotel. So the 2012 SK Central Luzon Summit, which is the Region 3 also. Now, ever since naman, just this reason, alam naman po ng lahat about the Sangguniang Kabataanan. A lot of people also clamoring for its abolishment, right? And for sure, one of those who are pro, so much as possible, we need the voice from the youth to represent us. But there are certain things also that you'd like to do away with. It means you're just simply asking for certain reforms. Can you give us more details?
Well, you know, when I came into Congress in 2010, and I was really surprised that a lot of our congressmen, especially the second, third termers, are in favor of abolishing the Sangguniang Kabataan altogether. So, in other words, gusto nilang matanggal na, no, yung SK. And according to them, I think they have their reasons, and some are valid, I think, no, that the SK did not serve its purpose as to mold the youth, no, and some of them say that it has become a breeding ground of trapos or traditional politicians, no? Mm-hmm. But my position is that it will be more detrimental if we abolish the SK, because it's better to have a youth program of the national government than none at all, no? Sabi ko, pag merong problema, pag merong sira, dapat ayusin, no? Hindi, just like a car, like an automobile, if a spare part of our part is non-functioning, we do not remove it, but we replace it and fix it, no? So, I'm one of those spearheading a move to pass the bill, no? On the SK reform, no? Instead of abolishing, we need to reform, no? We took all those points by those pro-abolition congressmen, and one of these is the age, no, factor, because right now the age of the Sagunting Kabataan is 15 to 17, which I think is very much prone to manipulation, no? It's not only the mayors, it's not only the governors or the congressmen or the barangay captains who manipulate, even some the parents. So if we raise the age, no, from 15 to 17, make it 18 to 24, I believe that we will lessen, no, the manipulation, because at that age, it is expected that the child or the youth is more politically aware, and at the same time, he will have his or her own disposition in life, no? And at the same time also, yung 15 to 17, we want them to prioritize their studies, no? And hopefully if we move it to 18 to 24, by the time they are already wrapping up their studies, or they have graduated already. So that's the main important, and probably the proposal, no?
Is top of the really, list, so
yes,
to speak.
Yes, yes.
So it's all about the age.
It's the age. Mm-hmm. And likewise, another bold move is that, which I think is bold, some pro-abolition congressmen are already amenable, no, to this SK reform, as long as, but we are still talking about it, they do not want the SKs to be part of to become ex-officio members,
okay,
of provincial
of, most
board.
Most of them are into also, yes, with the age changes.
Because according to them, this is one of the reasons that the politicians, no, are meddling in the affairs, because each SK federation head will become, it's a seat already, no, becomes a councillor as ex-officio member or a board member. So, but that one we are still debating about it. I think it will really remove, no, the manipulations, but we still feel that some sort of training would still be benefited, no, if the SK is an ex-officio member.
Okay. So, for those who just happened to tune in right now, medyo kaw-tunin nyo lang po sa 89.5. Ang kasalukuyang nangyayari po right now is that we're doing this live interview with Congressman JV Ejercito, of course, for the Sangguniang Kabataan thing that is happening right now at the Travelers Inn Hotel and Convention Center. So, it's Central Luzon. Now, if I may also, napag-usapan po natin yung top of the list ninyo is all about the change ng age qualification or the bracket. What do you think is on top of the list naman of those who are anti, those who'd like to abolish it?
Well, top of the list is that the SK is being used by some government officials and some parents for their own interests. No? As I've said earlier, since the SK Federation president or the head is entitled to become a councillor as an ex-officio member or of a city or a town or the provincial board, that's where the manipulation comes in. So that's the point.
The root word is manipulation, of
course.
A lack of experiential learning and perhaps maturity because of the age, 15 to 17.
Yes.
Not that we're saying everyone's part of it, but it just so happened that I think that is the majority according to. Okay, so.
And likewise, we are proposing that, you know, we will have a menu now that on what projects the SK would venture into, because.
Okay.
the pro-abolition congressmen saying that, you know, their funds are being used by not in the proper way, not in the not for youth programs. No? For example, yung mga waiting sheds,
oh, yes.
Garbage bins, or
not youth centered.
Not youth centered. Okay. No, it's supposedly the barangay's project, or sometimes yung mga there are projects like yung mga beauty contest, no, na mga Miss Gay na.
Typical po kasi.
I don't think ano. And I believe that personally, being an advocate of youth programs, I believe that the SK should center on leadership training, on entrepreneurship, on and in a lot of activities that would hone, no, the leadership qualities of the youth. So mas tingin ko dapat mag-focus sila talaga doon sa mga programa na leadership skills training that would really mold them to become future leaders of this country.
Okay. So right now, sir, ano na po, nasa ang level na po ba this clash between, you know, those who are into and against it?
Actually, we're before we adjourned, we were supposed to vote already, no? And I think right now, good news to our SKs, no, that we have a very big chance right now of winning, no, yung SK reform bill, no, that that it would be passed in the committee level and then be voted upon in the plenary. So one good news that I can pwede kong maibigay sa ating mga SKs all over Central Luzon and all over the country is that the SK most likely would be here to stay.
Cool. Two thumbs up, of course. Now, we got, of course, within the Olongapo City, Zambales, Bataan, Sfars, Pampanga, Greater Subic Bay Area, Sangguniang Kabataan representatives and officers. Ano po masasabi nyo sa mga nakikinig natin right now na Sangguniang Kabataan members? And those who are, of course, will be voting for?
Well, to our SKs, no, sa mga Sangguniang Kabataan, I just like to remind all of you that you are all public officials, and hopefully we can prove those the pro-abolition congressmen wrong. By I hope that you'll come up with projects that will be worthwhile and that would really be molding the future leaders of this country. And this is what the SK was envisioned to be, no? As a breeding. Should be the breeding ground of future leaders of this country. And hopefully with this SK reform, we will be going back to the original thrust of the for which the Sangguniang Kabataan was created.
Was created. So basically, it's just like putting it on the right path, you know, yes. Controlled path, so to speak. Because sometimes, pag masyadong broad, sir, di ba? Kalat-kalat eh. Mas maganda mailagay sa focus. Perhaps that's the main reason why. Okay, we are also live now via www.subictimes.com and of course via the 89.5 FM live streaming. Told you, we're worldwide. So kung maiba naman tayo ng konti to serve as culmination of this live interview, sir, ano pong balita naman po kay Congressman J.V. Ejercito? What's happening right now with you, sir?
Well, we're on break right now in Congress. And I've been going around because one of my advocacies aside from the Sangguniang Kabataan is I've been advocating increase of state subsidy for state universities and colleges because
that's great.
I've always looked at the youth as you know, we've always said that ang pag-asa ng bayan, no, yung kabataan. I believe in investing in our youth, no? And you know, in this world of globalization, the world has become smaller, and because of this, competition, I think, is stiffer. No, before we were just up against our kababayans. No, pag merong graduate, kalaban natin mga kapwa Pilipino. But now it's become worldwide. Ang we are up against a graduate would be up against, no, mga Vietnamese, Thai. Indonesians.
Tough competition.
Yes, it has become really because of globalization. I think the world has really become smaller, and because of this, I'm advocating that we should equip our youth with the necessary education and necessary skills that would put them above the rest. No, since after they graduate in our state colleges, that they would be better equipped, no, to go into kumbaga, in the war, no, so to speak, kumbaga, in the real world, in facing the challenges of the real world, that they would have an advantage over our Asian neighbors.
Sabi nga po sa Art of War ni Sun Tzu, information is definitely power. So it's all definitely important for you to be well informed and for studies. Now, right on the same path lang din, sir, matanong ko lang about first, of course, universities, state-run colleges, any possibility for Subic Bay Freeport Zone to, you know, well, be in the near future for us to have, but
well, sir? That would be nice, though, because but first and foremost, what we need in establishing a state university or a college is there should be a lot of students, no, yung population, no. Mm-hmm. So I believe we have in Olongapo or in Zambales, so we could put up a branch later on or a campus in Subic, and that would be really
that
nice.
That would be great.
And of course, and I would be 100% supportive of that project, because
well, you can be the proponent, sir. Why not?
Yes, if there is a demand and if there is enough population in our market for students here in Subic, I don't see any reason why we should not put up a state university here inside the zone. No? So, and, you know, I've been going around the country and I've visited more than 20 state universities and colleges, and they are really in a sad state right now. And that's why I'm advocating additional subsidy, you know, from the national government to these state universities and colleges, because it's really ironic, no? For your information, that, you know, every year, because of the population growth, the enrollees of these state universities are increasing every year, but the state subsidy has been decreasing.
Yeah,
it's not proportionate.
Yeah, it's not proportionate.
So, tumataas yung ating enrollees, yung ating student population, pero yung budget has through the years, I don't know for what reason, is that the budget has been decreasing. So that's what I've been fighting for the past. This will be the third year that I'll be debating, and I'll be fighting for this in Congress again this coming budget season.
Mas tumaas pa, of course, for the benefit of all of our students who are a little, you know. Now, okay, so sa lahat po na nakikinig right now, again, what's happening right now is we're doing the live interview with Congressman J.V. Ejercito with the ongoing 2012 SK Central Luzon Summit happening at the Travelers Inn. I got a couple of questions left na lang. First of the penultimate, actually, second to the last question, sir, if I may. What's the future for, ano po ba mga plano pa in the nearest future for Congressman J.V. Ejercito?
Well, actually, I interviewed last night also in Manila in a program called On the Road to 2013. Okay. Obviously, it's about the election, upcoming senatorial and local elections in 2013. To be honest with you, I'm really enjoying myself, I am really contented with my position right now as congressman. Mm-hmm. Since it's my first term, I've been mayor for 9 years, for three terms, and since more than half of Congress right now are composed of neophytes, no? So it's really nice because I feel that I'm in. I'm in college. It's a fun batch. Because a lot are young, no, more 40, 30, in their 40s, 30s, and even 20s. So I'm enjoying myself in Congress. But since the Pulse Asia survey came out last November, things kind of changed, no, and now I'm. And to be honest, right now, since my name is was in the magic, in the winning magic circle, I'm considering running for the Senate. But nothing is final, no, because there are a lot of things to consider. Of course, when I run in my district for re-election, I'll be running unopposed, no. So that's a big consideration. So there's no headache, lesser risk. But you know, running for the Senate, if the opportunity comes, will be a big opportunity for me to be able to serve most our countrymen, no, in a bigger scale, no, hindi lang yung aking distrito, at least yung buong ating mga kababayan. It will be, of course, an honor and a privilege. But like I said, nothing is final until the last day of the date of filing the certificate of candidacy.
No, we'll be looking forward for it. Now, my last question, sir, to wrap things up. Any final parting words you'd like to all of our listeners, international and of course local?
Well, to our kababayans, especially here in Central Luzon, here in Subic, and our kababayans all over, lalo na sa mga OFWs natin sa buong mundo. No? I'd like to thank all of you for listening, and if I may greet all our OFWs, of course, we always look at them as our new heroes. Now, without them, I guess our economy will be in a sad state. But because of their remittance, our economy is afloat. No? So, sa ating mga mabayang OFWs, mabuhay kayo. And I'd like to thank all of you for helping and keeping our country afloat. No? So, I'd like to thank all our OFWs. And of course, our kababayans here in Central Luzon, maraming salamat din sa yung pakikinig. And I'd like to greet all of you. Be rest assured that you have an ally in Congress, no? That I will always be fighting for the interests of the greater majority of our people.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Maraming salamat po for gracing this radio station of ours within Subic Bay, Freeport, and of course Greater Subic Bay Area, with your presence, of course. Ongoing ang ating 2012 SK Central Luzon Summit at the Travelers Inn and Convention Center. So you'll be heading there, sir,
yes,
to give out a speech centering on, of course, the different reforms that the Sangguniang Kabataan should have, yes, with this new bill that you filed for it. Well, thank you so very much, sir. I'm looking forward to the next time we're going to have you back here for another interview in the near future.
Thank you very much also for this opportunity, and it's a privilege to be able to visit your station in 89.5 Subic Bay. I hope to be able to visit you sometime in the future again. Thank you very much, and mabuhay.
Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap. We're going to have to take a short break, but before that, we're going to be playing Rihanna's You The One.
89.5.
This just in. Digital high-definition music starts now.
Now.
89.5.
Love, love, love. Baby, I love you, I need you here with me all the time.